Good morning, children. So yesterday we have studied about some properties, physical properties you can say that about matter. Today I am going to start with the next topic of the chapter, that is characteristic of these matter. When we are talking about these characteristics, basically we are having three characteristics of matter. First characteristics, that means the particles have space between them. Second, they keep on moving, they're continuously in movement. And the third property we are having, they attract each other. So for each and every property, we are having different examples from our day-to-day life even. Suppose, let me give you one small activity. How can we say that these particles, they have space between them? Let me take one example. Again, I am putting some water in it. And now I am taking a solution of laminate, that is lemon water. Simple lime water I have added in water. Now I am stirring it continuously. Yes. Can you see the different boundaries of laminate, lemon water and water in it? No. We cannot differentiate the boundaries of two liquids here. It means the lemon solution has taken the space between the water molecules. Get it? In the same way, we can have one more example. Suppose I am putting a pinch of salt in it and I am again stirring it again and again. Whatever the space is left between the water and the laminate solution, it is taken up by salt molecules. That's why it is completely disappearing. After some time, you will not get it back. Got it? Here, you cannot separate water, laminate and salt molecules, which proves that these all matter, they have already adjusted themselves between the space provided by other type of molecules. Like in this example, we have seen in the space between the water molecules, the salt molecules and lemon water has taken its place. Got it? Which proves that the state of matter, or you can simply say that the matter, they are having spaces between them. Okay? Second property, they keep on moving from one place to another place. Let me prove this by a simple activity. Again, let me take the solution back. Now I am going to add, this is a color powder I am having. This is blue color powder. Day to day life mein aap isko use karte ho washing ke liye. Main ek simple sa small, I am adding a pinch of blue color solution in this water. After some time, you can see how the color of the water has changed to blue color. It means as soon as I have put the pinch of this blue color component, it takes the space and it has moved to all the particles of the water and started adjusting between them. The presence of this blue color shows that the molecules of this blue color component, or you can say that this powder, is continuously moving and they are continuously taking their space. So from one position to another position, all the particles have taken their place. You can also take one more example. Chalk we are having. If you put some ink on the chalk, what will be there? What change you will be observing? You will observe after some time the chalk becomes blue. Why? Because the blue color ink will easily float and it can move from one place to another place. It proves that first thing, they are keep on moving. Second, they have space between them. And thirdly, the liquids are having intermolecular spacing between them, which can easily adjust other particles. Got it? Now, let us try about the third property. The third property of the particles are, they attract each other. What is the meaning of this? Suppose, I am having pen in my hand. Okay. I am having this marker in my hand. Can I break them? No, I can't. Can I break this wood? No, I cannot. But instead of this, suppose if I'll be having chalk, it can be easily broken. It means there is a force of attraction, a strong force of attraction between the particles of this marker and this pen. But there is a space and less intermolecular force of attraction between the chalk particles, which make them brittle and they can easily be broken. Thank you. Have a nice day.